So the Garmin 945, of course, the successor to the 935, which was the best multi-sport watch in my opinion then, and also what I hear from other like runners and cyclists. I don't know a lot of swimmers, but I think for swimming the 935 was perhaps not the best one, but yeah, just for running and cycling, certainly it was the best one. The new one, the 945, has a lot more function. Of course, it is a little bit more expensive. It has the music, how do you call it? The alarm messaging when you fall down when cycling. Of course, DI2 connection, VO2, SpO2, a lot of other functions. Yeah, if you like it for like the looks of it, it's just up to you, of course. I think for perhaps like men with really small wrists, it's a little bit big, not too big, but kind of big. Lots of women, I think they like the Fitbit Versa more, but just if you are like a real marathoner, triathlete, if you like just all the smart data, which also was on the Fenix 5, I think the 945 will be a very good choice with more functions than the Fenix 5, which is more expensive. So let's just dive into all the details. So I just put it back to the just first screen that you see when you just buy the watch, like I did, and just want to show you everything you see when you just start it up. Let's just clean it a little bit because it was a little bit sweaty. But I just put it back. I just uploaded all the training, so it's just good. So let's just see how it goes. I didn't read the manual, of course. Don't pair the phone because I will be doing that later. The phone is filming this. I want kilometers, 24 hours. What you hear is like the safe mode from the 245. I'll just show you it. The 245, this is the music version of the 245. The music is standard on the 945, but you can choose on the 245 if you just want to buy the normal one without the music for $300, and you pay $350 with the music on the 945. And as you know, it is way more expensive. You get always the music. Let's go further with this. Yeah, it's okay. No, it's not okay. 188. Yeah, this a little bit less. So set time set. Of course, you are inside. You see the GPS is there. GPS chipset is from Sony. Some people criticize Sony, but I think Sony is kind of okay. It has a GPS, it's also compatible with the Galileo, the Russian and also the European GPS set. It's almost there. So let's just wait a little bit more, just show you like the details. Two buttons on the right with here a small back logo, and it's, you see that also here written like in the circle around the bezel. The bezel doesn't like twist to make that very sure. So the start stop button with a little how do you call it, little thing inside, we call it inkeping in Dutch, but don't know the English word, sorry for that. The light, but you can read it like this, the light button with the also the power switch here. Just want to zoom in for you, but it's not helping me this time. The menu, which you can see like this little menu icon, and just arrows down for the lap. Yeah, I think so. Oh, there it is. So you also know how fast this is, looking for the satellites for the GPS inside. The battery is almost full. Sun is going down, 2102, but of course you can change this screen to your preferred. Or so you can change like the looks of it, like if you want the old fashioned or real modern. You can of course use the Garmin app for that also. And like always, like this is a real sport watch, but you can also use it as like a smartwatch for daily activity tracking for your messages on the watch, for phone calls, like WhatsApp messages, etc. What we will do is just show you how you start a race. That's how easy it is. It's like the same on as on every other Garmin. So yeah, you can see those screens. Of course, we can tweak them. This is the lap button here on the right below. If you want, just stop it. Stop and play, or start, not play, start. And if we just want to stop it, you just wait a little bit, and then we can say resume, save, resume later, or back to start. Of course, the 935 has like all the options from the Fenix 5. Like, oh, here we are. This Fenix 5, this is the plus version of it, which is way bigger. Let's show you that very quickly. Zoom in, please. Yeah. So 935 is way lighter. It looks not like that plasticky as like the old one, and especially not like the 735 XT, which was real plastic like. But this looks like a real sturdy watch, but it's so much lighter than this very weighty Fenix 5. And of course, yeah, the Fenix, yeah, you see the torque screws on the bezel. It looks more like a military watch. I like it, but lots of people think it's like too massive, too big. So it's just up to you. For sports, I think this is just like better. But actually, I bought this just to be testing it and compared it with the 935, because it was like on the market like a year ago, and I was just waiting for this one. That's how easy it is. So you get there we complete the course, and we get a nice tune. Oh, we were just back at the place. Yeah. Okay, let's stop this, and now so save this. Then we see the running stats on this very silent sitting activity, but like always, it's measuring something. It's very nice. So I did a little bit, but the training effect was not big. But you have like the, all the running dynamics on the 935. You get the VO2 max measurement, the SpO2. You get the stress measurement, all the activity tracking. You get the ultra track modus to like make the battery life longer. So if you are just sporting for one whole day, you can use the ultra track mode. And of course, yeah, then you don't have to be worried about is the battery life okay. So let's just see all the stats. Kind of boring for this one, but yeah, I just did 1 calorie, so that's good. Average heart rate, max, aerobic, the anaerobic training load. So you get also on the 935 the battery, the body battery. Let's just show you this. No benefit. Kind of. That's a bummer, but yeah. Heart rate. It was measuring something for me, kind of a high heart rate when sitting still, but yeah, it's just the way it is. So the laps, the map, which I did. So yeah, let's show you this. The tips. The tips won't appear like a second time, but first time they are. No. Just want to show you. Just zoom in. Here we are. So, zoom out. There we are. Push this one, yeah? Then we are like going to the right, going to the left. You see those three circles? That's for this button. See it? So this is the zoom out function. Zoom out, zoom out. See how quickly the processor is? So that's like on also the Garmin Edge, the 830 and the 530, the processor is way better than the old ones like the 820 and the 520 Plus. On this Garmin 945, the processor is also getting better. See, it's well zooming. How quickly it shows you the map of the Netherlands. You see Amsterdam not on the correct position. But yes, yeah, like you have to put in all the details on like a small screen. So we see like Paris, Berlin, London is appearing. That's just Europe. Let's zoom out. That's the most zoomed out version. And this is just how you get it. So I didn't install any maps as you saw. It's just, this is how it just, yeah, how you buy it. And that's very easy. I buy also other like navigation devices for the bike and also running watches. But like maps is by some brands always, yeah, you have to just put on some maps and just do some boring stuff like half an hour before you find it out. And on the Garmin, it's just there. So I like that a lot. So I think it looks good, the maps. See how detailed it is if you just, oh, let's go back to the map. I want to go like down, 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 down. So just search for a place. Zoom a little bit out now. We are in the middle of nowhere. So go down. Go down. So yeah, now I want to zoom in. So let's see how good it says the street name. So you see the in the course, so that's how the street is called. It's like Duck Cage, I think. So it's kind of funny, but it's, yeah, it's not the place where we are, of course. I was just swiping a little bit. So it's not like that you can swipe like this. So you have to use the buttons. I like the buttons touch because, yeah, a finger on here, you don't see a lot of the screen. So that's kind of nice. You see the sunlight now on the screen, but you see the details. So this is very, very detailed. It's not like you have to guess where you are. You can just see it. And yeah, it's, it goes so quickly. So let's zoom out. See how quickly it loads again. So there we are. So I think this is really what you want on a running watch. Of course, you pay a big price for the 945. But yeah, you don't have to take your phone. It's just on the watch. And with the Garmin Pay option, with the music on the device, yeah, it's just, I think, what you want. Yeah, let's go just back. So this is a run. If you can choose other ones, you can choose all the sports that you want. Of course, you can add all kind of sports here, like row indoor. So who is doing that, row indoor? So golfing. Like everything is on here, like not everything, but yeah, a lot of sports. If you want more, I think there isn't a watch on the market that you can buy. So watch faces, just, yeah, like just take this one, apply, and then you can also just customize it. Oh yeah, go back, just push this again, the menu. So this is the menu, as you saw. The alarm clock, boring, history, apps. So then we can all tweak that, of course. Also like the data screens, what's on the data screens, the number of, are like the stats on one screen. And you can change that per every sport. Don't hope that the sunlight is, yeah, it's a little bit on the video, so sorry for that. The widgets, the training status, I don't know what they reorder. So what's reordering mean? Perhaps it's just because there's nothing here. So health stats. Oh, reorder, yeah, just nothing here. SpO2, it's telling you how good your breathing is, how effective it is. So normally it should be above 95%, so 98 is very good, 93 is not good, but this is not like replacing a real medical test. I just wanted to make this clear. I think garments are good, but yeah, sometimes they are going a little bit too far perhaps, so people just rely on this watch. And this is not a replacement for any physician, not for any doctor, in my opinion. Music controls. Oh, you can just reorder those items. Yeah, okay. Yeah, history. So that's this function. Just show you where we came from. Controls. So you can have the, like, the emergency function. So if you are riding on the bike, if you just fall down, it you can set it up to like just contact your ICE person which you set up. If you get that message, you can cancel it if you fall down but don't, or if you just stand still after very high speed. And it wants to send a message, you can cancel it. If you go like moving again after it, it will also cancel it. And what's nice about it, if you are just, if it's really necessary, so if you fall down, you break something, you're not conscious anymore, you go with the ambulance, then it will live track by the person that is set up. That person will see where you are, to which hospital you are going, etc. So that's really it is on other systems, and it has saved real people, so it's a real function that you can use. The watch faces, we were there by the watch face. Perhaps I shoot my head. No, wait a minute. So back without the sunlight, sorry for that. The wrist heart rate, all the sensors, so you can add so much. So like your race bike is the pulse oxy meter, so let's put it on. When sleeping, you get here the information, the all day mode, the compass, the height. You can also measure the temperature. Everything is on this. So music providers, these are the Spotify, and you can also put on music, so connect it to the computer and put on some music. Connect headphones, Bluetooth headphones of course, if you are just listening to the music, don't want to take your phone. So that's nice and new on this one. A lot of functions of the, well, which are on here but none on the 935, but were on the newer Fenix 5 Plus, are now also on the 945. And some more, so that's good to know. So did we see every function? Of course not, because it's almost impossible to show you, but yeah, just show you. Oh, this is the safety and tracking, so the incident detection assistance. Also you can just call somebody, so put it up if you're like follow, you're not really safe, if you feel like that, if someone is following you, you can make a quick button and just send a message to the person you set up. So that's nice. So you should connect it here. The group track function, we also saw that in other Garmin products of course. So where were we? So yeah, lock everything, then activity tracking, we saw the map orientation, you can just set it up, navigation, and the system. Let's show you. Show the heading bug. Yes, of course. There you are, the data screens, the map on the guide. Elevation, yeah, it has the elevation mode for the VO2 max. So it will take in the height which you are in. So if you are like above 850 meters, if you are like climbing in the Alps or something, it will get those numbers also to make the VO2 more accurately. And what it also will do is see how warm it is outside. If it's like 30 degrees or higher, it will take that in notice for more correct measurement, because in history some people told Garmin that, and perhaps they already knew, but it's now also on the 9V5, so that's also nice. And there we are, just here. So this just the on off button and the light, and there I think we have like not every function, but you just saw a quick 20 minutes, not a very quick summary. The bill, I just pay for the product, so it's not like sponsored product. To be honest, I think the 945 is really, really, really expensive. This 245 is way more affordable with $300 and $350 for the music version, which is this one. But it's also not cheap. The 935 has lots and lots of more functions. So is it worth the price? In my opinion, it is, but it's a hard one, because yeah, if you really want a real smartwatch, please buy a Samsung Galaxy Watch or an Apple Watch, because it is way better in the really smartwatch functionality. But if you just want to have the best watch for multisports, if you just want all the details for analyzing, for logging, for just checking it, and for a very long battery life, I think this one will be the main watch to beat in the coming years. We'll see that, of course, because it's now like brand new, but let's just see how it works. I will be using it while running, cycling, swimming, and in winter also some ice skating. So, hope you liked the very long video. Yeah, I will be coming back on this channel. Please subscribe and please rate it with a thumb. Okay, bye.